Everyone, welcome to my video lecture. Myself, Sushma Rao, Assistant Professor in Commerce, working at MPM Government First Aid College, Karkala. In this video, let us understand the meanings of various definitions of various terms given under GST Act. Okay? Yes. So, as we know that GST is a tax which is applicable on supply of goods as well as services. Now let us know what is the meaning of goods and what is the definition given by the GST Act. As per section 252 of GST Act, goods means every kind of movable property other than money and securities, but includes auctionable claims for growing crops, grass and things attached to the farming of part of land. Okay, in this definition we have to observe two important things. One is that it is the tax goods includes every kind of movable property. It does not include immovable property. It includes all kinds of movable property which you can take from one place to another place, but it does not include money as well as securities, shares, debentures, etc. Money is not goods. In the same way, securities is also not goods as per that. Okay, but it includes if there is any grass or any crops which are attached to the land. For example, you are having one estate, there is crop, okay, it has grown up and you are selling this crop to somebody, some purchaser, okay, when it is still on the ground. Okay, now this supply of these things, crops, is considered as what? Goods, even though it is immovable. Later you can move it, you can take it off. That's why it is considered as what? Goods. So, if you summarize the definition of goods, it includes every kind of movable property, right? It includes auctionable claims as well, right? And it includes growing crops, grass, things attached to the land. But it does not include two important things, that is securities and money. Securities and money are not considered under the meaning and definition of the term goods. Now, let us see what is the meaning of place of supply. Here, we know that while determining the taxability and levy of tax, the place of supply is very important. Okay, sometimes the concern may have the branches in different places, and one branch can instruct to supply the goods to another branch. In such cases, which will be the place of supply? So, to understand this, we should go through the meaning of this place of supply. As per the Act, place of supply is nothing but the place of delivery of goods. Where the goods are delivered, okay, then it is considered as place of supply. Let me give a small example. You are in Udupi, right? You place an order through Amazon or Flipkart and you order for a mobile phone, right? And you want to give this mobile phone as a gift to your friend who is in Maharashtra. Okay, now you are in Bangalore, you are in Udupi, you ordered and you order through Amazon, right? And the goods are not delivered to you, instead of it is delivered to your friend who is in Maharashtra. Now, which is the place of supply? Even though it is ordered by you who is in Karnataka, since the goods are delivered to Maharashtra, Maharashtra is considered as place of supply. That means where the goods are delivered or where the goods are consumed, then that is considered as place of goods, that is place of supply. Okay, the next is that, okay, in case of import and export of goods, for example, if you import the goods from foreign country, what is the place of supply? We import to India. India is a place of supply. Okay, yes. The next is that agent. Who is agent? As per the Act, agent is any person. He may be broker or factor, or he may be commission agent, Del Crider agent, where there should be a main principal. If there is principal and this agent, this person is acting on behalf of that principal, then that person is considered as what? Agent. Next, who is principal? Principal is nothing but he is a person who owns and the goods or services, and who does all the work through his agent. So principal is a owner of business. He is a person on behalf of whom an agent does the work, carries on the business. Now, related person. Sometimes some business may have the multiple branches across India. In such cases, all these branches might have different registration number under GST. Now, even though these are having separate registration numbers, all are considered as the related person because all are coming under single ownership. The next is regarding casual taxable person. Who is casual taxable person? Casual taxable person is a person who supplies taxable goods and services occasionally, once in a while. He is not the regular dealer. He is not the regular supplier of goods and services. Once in a while, in a certain occasions he supplies the goods or services, then he is taxable under GST. He should pay the tax under GST as a casual taxable person. The next is regarding services. The two important terms under GST: goods and services. What is services? As per section 102 of GST Act, services means anything other than goods, money and securities. A very simple definition. Anything other than goods, money and securities, but includes activities relating to use of money. There should be payment of money, right? Or there should be transfer of money for use of such services, such thing. Okay, then that is considered as service. There will not be any supply of goods. Instead, there is benefit which is received by the customer. Now, let us see what is job work. As per the definition, job work is nothing but any treatment or process undertaken by a person on goods belonging to another registered person. For example, you are a dealer and you order to manufacture certain goods to somebody else. So, you have received an order, right? Instead of you are doing this work, you delegate this authority and responsibility of manufacturing goods to somebody else. Then that person is called as job worker, and the work you have given to him is called as job work. For example, you received an order to manufacture laddus for a function. Okay, you have to manufacture 10,000 laddus. You are the caterer. Now, if you are busy and if you have some more business opportunities, what you can think is you can give the work of manufacturing and manufacturing of these laddus to another caterer who will manufacture on behalf of you, and he will supply the laddus to you, and in turn you supply the laddus to your customer. So the work you have given to another caterer is nothing but job work. Okay, yes. So the next is nothing but works contract. Works contract, it is a commonly used word in case of construction or any contract works, etc. So, in case of works contract, all these terms are very important under GST, because here under GST, while levying GST, the place of supply is important. So, to determine the place of supply, the definitions and the meaning of these terms should be clearly understood. For example, you are the hardware shop owner in Mangalore, and you got a contract to construct a bridge in Andhra Pradesh. Now, you are taking all the materials from Mangalore to Andhra Pradesh, and there you are constructing a building. In such cases, which is a place of supply? The place of supply will be Andhra Pradesh, because here in case of works contract, where the thing is manufactured, where this benefit is used, consumed, then that particular place is considered as what? Works contract. So, all these are the few important definitions we should be known to any person to understand the remaining aspects of GST. I hope this is understood. Thank you.